there is a standard formula to calculate the bright fringe condition. You should equate this path difference to n lambda when we will find the condition of bright fringe. So delta is equals to n lambda for constructive interference. So here the delta is 2t plus lambda by 2 is equals to n lambda. Here we are calculating the condition of bright fringe. So 2t is equals to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. यहाँ पे हम क्या कैलकुलेट करेंगे, 2t is equals to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. This is the condition of bright fringe. When you have to find the condition of dark fringe, then equate this path difference to the 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. So 2t plus lambda by 2 is equals to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. Okay, then solve it, find the value of 2t here, then 2t is equals to n lambda. So we have the two conditions, one is for bright fringe and another for dark fringe. Bright fringe condition is 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, and dark fringe condition is 2t is equals to n lambda. Okay, here n is equals to 1, 2, 3 and lambda is the wavelength of the light used. So remember the important point here, that in case of Newton's ring experiment, we are always observed from the reflected portion or the reflected region. So we are calculating the interference from the reflected beams of the light. Hence the lambda by 2 is added in the path difference, that is the effective path difference. So this is the experimental setup of Newton's ring experiment. So in the figure number 2, initially you are observing the plain glass plate which is noted by the point P, and afterward there is a plano convex lens C and one glass plate is also there which is inclined at angle of 45 degree. Here at the right side there is a sodium lamp, and we are observing from the traveling microscope at upside. So as you switch on the lamp, the light will incident towards the plain glass plate which is inclined at 45 degree angle. The light is coming from the sodium lamp having wavelength 5890 angstrom. It is incident towards the glass plate which is inclined at 45 degree angle. After reflection, it will bend towards the plain glass plate and plano convex lens normally. They are bending normally. When the light falls normally to the second medium, the refraction of the light takes place on the same path I have explained earlier. So you can see the light is incident at the plain glass plate and then it will fall downward to the plain glass plate, and again there is a reflection from the plain glass plate P, and light is moving towards the traveling microscope. So there is a reflection of light at the point C and at the center of the plate P. Okay, so there is a interference in between the two light beams which is reflecting from the plain glass plate and bottom of the plano convex lens, and the fringes are observing in the same region of the air film which is formed in between plano convex lens and the plain glass plate. Okay, so rings are formed in the region of air film, and we are observing the rings which are in circular in shape like this. Okay, you can see the rings like this. The center is always dark because at the point of contact T, the value of T is 0. You can see in this equation we have the equation delta, that is 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2. When r is equals to 0, the equation will become 2 mu t plus lambda by 2. The air refractive index is 1, so it will be 2 t plus lambda by 2. So at the point of contact, the value of t is 0. Hence, we will observe the dark fringe at the center. Because you can see in this figure that at the point of contact of plano-convex lens and the plain glass plate, the value of t is 0. Hence, we are observing the dark fringe at the center. Then after, there is a bright fringe, then dark, alternative dark and bright fringes are observed because of constructive and destructive interference pattern. So, this type of a structure is observed in the Newton's ring experiment. And with the help of this ring pattern, we will find the diameter of the rings. So, the same rings can be observed in the instrument also.